Ladies and gentlemen, moving on to our next bout this evening. This is a standard MMA, 145-pound amateur fight. Welcoming first, ladies and gents, in the blue corner, fighting out of Frontline MMA. Welcome into the cage, Tommy Socorgrim. And welcome his opponent into the red corner, fighting out of Sarpsborg, Chi. Welcome into the cage, Henrik Persson.
No knees to the head, no elbows whatsoever, okay? Yeah. So you're going to protect yourselves at all times.
Here we go, a featherweight amateur competition. Henrik Persson in the blue corner representing Sarpsborg Chi, taking on Tommy Skallgrim in the black, take from Frontline MMA, and two Scandinavian amateurs going at it here.
Coming out just swinging for the fences at this point.
Persson obviously 1-1 here, obviously with a 2-0 record, 1-1 here at BC MMA. Skallgrim with the same record, but making his BC MMA or Cage Warriors Academy debut, and a bit of a trip.
Yeah, but it was a trip off of a front kick that Tommy actually took right to the face and just walked through it.
Persson throwing those legs up high. Eating a few shots, but trying to tighten up that triangle.
And
has he got it?
Yes, he does. He's...
Oh, a transition to the arm.
Working the hips just right to at least defend from it. That was a nice little scramble.
Skallgrim did well there.
See, Henrik rushed it a bit, and I think that was one of the biggest problems. He was good on the triangle, and then as soon as he thought he didn't have it anymore, he went right into that arm bar, but he rushed it a bit too quick, and he didn't have the right positioning for it, so...
Now are we perhaps seeing a similar setup here?
Yeah, he's riding very, very high with that guard, keeping the hands nice and tight, keeping that head low.
Yeah, looking to lock down Persson.
Hey, yeah, don't take any damage. Don't take any punches. Try and figure out a way. You know, we're back to the three rounds. So even if you lose this first one because of positioning or something like that, you got two more to.
You can make the adjustments.
Exactly.
Scott, again, that.
Oh, high on that guard.
Person doing the right thing, trying to just keeping the head and the chest there.
Yeah, he's keeping his arms in the right position, so he's not going to lose them. The one thing I would say is you want to sometimes just open up those legs a little bit, and you can do that by just sticking your knee right in the bum.
Yeah.
It helps. It alleviates some of that pressure from that high guard.
Skogren really working to lock this triangle up.
Hendricks is smart, though. He keeps both arms in. He's keeping his shoulders nice and tight so they're not getting rolled out. And he's keeping the head right on the center line.
Person with the control here throughout most of the round. Skogren looking to try and land a few little shots from his back.
He's been offensive off his back the entire time he was on it, so it was at least good. He was trying to position a way to where he could get in for that submission.
And so we go into we're getting ready to go into our second round.
So if I'm sitting in the corner, one of the biggest things behind it is I'm telling Tommy, I'm just telling him, look. If you do end up on top, let's be very careful because those submissions are coming. Now, bad thing is if I'm in Hendrick's corner, I'm telling him the same exact thing. So maybe for both of them, let's try and see what happens standing and fight at range.
Seemed like in the first round, Skogren was the more aggressive on the feet, maybe a little heavier, which is why Person
close that distance, but it'll be interesting to see how they come out after both of them spending a bit of time on bottom in that first round.
So Person marked up a little bit around the face. Skogren, he only ate one leg, one low kick, but he's wearing the mark on that, of that as well.
Yeah.
Pace notice will be a little bit slower the kickoff of this round.
Well, there was a lot of scrambling and a lot of grappling that took place, and for those of you that have never actually grappled, that takes a lot out of you, even if it's only 3 minutes. As long as it's a constant motion and there's a lot of scrambles going on, that can actually wear you out a bit.
Skogren looked to close the distance, but Person circled out.
Person's nice and light on his toes. I like to see this. He's on his toes the entire time. He's kind of got that in and out. He's working the lurk angles. He just needs to start throwing that jab a bit more. Looks like he's hesitant to put his hands out there.
And it's Tommy Skogren looking perhaps to counter-strike a little too much. He says as he leads with the big kick.
Oh.
Can't see where.
I can see that he's blocked that arm. Oh, he had the arm blocked, but smart enough he was able to try and push that shoulder through.
Well.
Again, that knee in the bum, that will help to alleviate. You'll be able to pull that head out. We got a attempt again at that triangle, and he was able to get that second shoulder through.
The Person seems to have a little more range on him. He seems to be a little longer. And does that help with the defense here?
It doesn't. It's sometimes a double-edged sword.
Oh.
Roll through. Doing the smart thing, going to that body lock.
So, a very different, not a position I've seen often in MMA.
What it is that usually what ends up happening is it exactly what is there. It saves yourself from the omoplata, but it puts you in the position to where now all of a sudden you're fighting off of your back.
Be interesting to see whether Skogren's going to look to jump into the guard or whether or not he's going to let the man stand up. Throws the legs to the side, tries to.
I wouldn't say throw the legs to the side.
Tossed it.
he kind of pushed it a little bit as he fell into it. He was hesitant at the up kick, which was smart, but he did do it in kind of slow-mo.
Yeah, I'm not sure I'm in a position where I can be quite that critical of the grappling prowess of the guys in the cage just yet. But I'll allow you to.
That's fine.
Again, this is 10 seconds left in this. Oh, ooh, he ate a big shot there at the end of the round. Skogren landing heavy at the end there, but
it's kind of a tale of two tapes. And what it is if you look at the corners, okay, Henrik looks, I wouldn't say worse from wear, but he does look like he's not as confident.
Yeah. Yeah, he wears.
Tommy looks a bit relaxed. He's staring right into his coach's eyes. He's making sure he's shaking his head yes and understanding what's going on.
Yeah, looking at the body language in the two corners.
Tommy's smiling, he's laughing, he's shaking his head, everything's cool. Henrik looks intense.
Third and final round here.
Both boys smiling.
Referee Rich Mitchell starts us off. Our third and final round here at the Cage Warriors Academy Southeast. Henrik Persson in the black and yellow taking on Tommy Skogren.
Still light on his feet, Persson.
Yeah, he's on his toes. He's going in and out. And again, I said it in the first, I said it in the second. I don't think he's throwing that jab enough. As light as he is on his feet and as heavy as Tommy is on his feet, if he's throwing that jab and he continues to do what he's doing, he's going to be able to land at will and set something up. Tommy's kind of just walking him down going, okay, let's see what you got. Maybe I'll counter. Maybe I'll throw that head kick, get you to get your hands up, and I'll take you down again.
Ooh. Heavy kick to the body. Oh, he landed. Defending well, trying to fight back off the cage. Skogren following him.
One of the things with Tommy is he's throwing his punches from his hips. And if I was Henrik, you can throw that jab, it'll land, and it'll alleviate some of that distance to where he's not getting hit by those punches.
And Skogren, hands a little bit lower now. Looks to be gaining in a bit of confidence. Certainly looks happy standing in the pocket throwing shots.
Ooh. Clipped him with that head kick. Henrik's backing up, trying to clear those cobwebs.
Straight from Skogren got through as well. He's not rushing.
Now Tommy just seems to be walking it down, going, okay, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to throw my punches from my hips. I'm going to go 1-2, 1-2, throw a body kick. 1-2, 1-2, throw a head kick.
Yeah.
Like I said, 1-2, 1-2, throw a head kick.
Persson does look a little bit rocked, a little bit tired, and Skogren working the body.
Now, I don't know if it's Skogren's arms are tired from all the grappling, so he's not throwing with a lot of power, but he's still landing.
Absolutely. And he keeps, you know, although they don't seem... The referee steps in and has seen enough.
I mean, it was smart. Henrik wasn't defending himself in a way. He wasn't throwing punches back. And it looked like he might have been, you know, he had gotten hit by that head kick early on and it might not have been able to clear the cobwebs. So.
No, fair play to Tommy Skogren. He landed and then he just stayed busy, 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 busy.
I mean, one of the things that everybody's got to understand as well is these are amateur kids. We do not want them to ever be in a position where they're going to get hurt. So yeah, safety is of the utmost concern. Some people might be like, oh, well, you know, he wasn't rocked too bad or he wasn't dropped or he wasn't knocked out, but he was obviously hurting. He's still in some way, shape, or form not at 100%. So.
Yeah, no complaints from the corner or the fighter tells me that's absolutely the right decision for sure.
We have your winner in the third round due to referee stoppage in the blue corner, Tommy Segre.